What if I told you the key to making better decisions isn't just in your brain, but in your gut? That's right. Your gut bacteria are secretly pulling the strings on your decisions. Stick around and I'll explain how. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos to strengthen your mind, fortify your brain, and build resilience. Today, we're looking into the fascinating new research on how your gut bacteria influence your decisions. If you've watched my other videos on this topic of gut bacteria, you know about the gut-brain connection. If you haven't, I'll link those videos to this video. But for now, I'll give you a quick refresh on the gut-brain connection. Think of it as a two-way street where your gut and your brain are in constant communication through the vagus nerve. In fact, the trillions of organisms in your gut called the microbiome are so influential that they're sometimes called your second brain. If you want more details on this, check out my previous videos on the gut-brain axis. Today, we're focusing on new stuff. Let's start with what recent research tells us about decision-making, and this is where it gets fascinating. Scientists have discovered that people with healthier gut bacteria populations tend to be more careful with risk-taking behavior and more future-oriented decisions. They even process emotional information differently, particularly when it comes to recognizing and responding to emotions. But it's not just about emotion, it's about fundamental decision-making processes. And here's the science behind this. Gut bacteria influence the production of about 95% of your body's serotonin. They also influence dopamine production and other neurotransmitters that are essential for decision-making. These bacteria even affect how much tryptophan is available in your brain. And serotonin is made from tryptophan, so tryptophan is considered a precursor to serotonin. Here's another interesting point. Research has found that people with better gut health tend to prioritize fairness in decision making. Scientists believe this happened through multiple pathways: direct neurotransmitter production, signaling through the vagus nerve, and even by influencing how much inflammation occurs in your body, which can affect how your brain functions. And how do the bacteria do this? Your gut bacteria produce hundreds of metabolites, and these are chemical compounds that directly influence your brain's signaling systems. Electrical systems is how your nerves communicate with each other. So these bacterial metabolites change how your nerve circuits function, including areas responsible for emotional processing and executive function. But here's another new area of research: postbiotics. You've probably heard of probiotics, the live bacteria that are good for your gut, and prebiotics, the fibers that feed these bacteria. But postbiotics? These are the next step in the chain. Postbiotics are bioactive compounds that gut bacteria produce when they ferment prebiotic fibers. And some examples are short-chain fatty acids like butyrate, and then enzymes, peptides, and even certain vitamins. Postbiotics are important because they're the ones doing the heavy lifting. For example, butyrate, one of the most studied postbiotics, strengthens the gut lining, reduces inflammation, and helps regulate serotonin production. All of these changes directly impact your mood and even your ability to handle stress. Other postbiotics, including enzymes and peptides, have been shown to support immune function and reduce harmful bacteria in the gut. Scientists are even exploring postbiotics as therapeutic tools for conditions like metabolic syndrome, obesity, and inflammatory diseases. For everyday use, though, the focus is on eating the right foods to naturally boost your postbiotic production. Now, let's say you decide to change your diet to improve your gut health. How long does it take to see changes in brain function? Here's what the research shows. Initial changes in gut bacterial composition begin by days 4 to 14. The first noticeable improvements in mood and mental clarity show up in weeks 2 to 6. You can even see positive changes in your emotional processing and decision-making. Then in months 2 to 3, you get more long-term adaptations in neural pathways. What I find interesting about this timeline is the traditional serotonin antidepressants like Prozac and Lexapro also take about 2 to 6 weeks to see some improvement in your symptoms. So as far as timing of change, the prescription medications don't outperform the bacteria. Now, the effect of prescription meds is stronger, but it's still empowering to know that even smaller changes to your brain are within your control through diet. Speaking of change, studies suggest that the postbiotics that I just talked about might accelerate these changes. Postbiotics appear to have a stronger and faster effect on changing the gut microbes and changing cognitive function. Another positive feature of them is that they have an extended shelf life and are more stable than probiotics. So how can you apply this to your life? Here are five practical suggestions. First, diversify your diet. Aim for 30 different types of plant-based foods each week, and this variety produces a diverse gut population, which means more robust postbiotic production. Now, 30 different plants might sound overwhelming, but it's more achievable than you might think. For example, a simple meal of a mixed salad with lettuce, tomatoes, cucumbers, and pumpkin seeds already gives you 4 plants. Add quinoa with mixed vegetables for dinner, throw in some berries and nuts in your breakfast, and you're already at 10 to 12 different plants just in one day. Herbs and spices count too, so that dash of basil or turmeric in your cooking, it's also contributing to your weekly variety. Second, experiment with fermented foods. If you're new to foods like kimchi or kefir, start small. Even a few spoonfuls can introduce beneficial bacteria to your gut. Third, boost fiber intake. Add chia seeds or flax seeds to your meals. They're easy to incorporate into smoothies or oatmeal. Fourth, limit artificial sweeteners. These can disrupt your bacterial metabolism. Fifth, maintain consistent meal times to support bacterial rhythms. Even microorganisms have circadian rhythms and thrive with predictable schedules. Here's a pitfall to avoid. Don't fall into the supplement trap right away. Although specific postbiotic supplements are becoming available, the research shows that food-based sources combined with a healthy diet provide the most beneficial effects on decision-making processes. Also, be realistic about timing. Some people notice improvements in mental clarity within days, but the deep changes in decision-making patterns typically take 6 to 8 weeks to establish. This aligns with how long it takes to form new neural pathways in the brain. Looking to the future, researchers are now investigating how specific postbiotic compounds might be used to enhance decision-making in high-stress situations or improve emotional regulation. And this could have huge implications for building mental resilience and managing stress-related decisions. Beyond just making better decisions, it's building a more resilient brain. The compounds produced by your gut bacteria play a central role in protecting your brain cells, reducing inflammation, and supporting cognitive function as you age. Think of it as creating a positive feedback loop. Better gut health leads to better decisions, which often leads to choices that further support gut health. This self-reinforcing cycle is a powerful way to build lasting resilience. So what's your next step? Start with one change, maybe adding a fermented food to your daily meals, and observe how your mental clarity and decision-making evolve over the next few weeks. Building a resilient mind starts with small, consistent changes that strengthen your habits and enhance your ability to adapt to stress. Incremental improvements like adding nutrient-rich foods or practicing mindfulness can create lasting benefits for both mental and physical resilience over time. Thanks for watching today. If you want to learn more about building mental resilience through brain science, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. See you in the next video.